Among the discoveries are a collection of copper coins. Wolfgang Schlutter, director of the museum, believes that they hold the answer.
Wir haben hier eine solche Kupfermünze.
Here we have a copper coin, of which we have found about 200 so far. These are surely only a fraction of the coins lost here. And these coins are the best way to date this event.
Roman soldiers were paid in copper coins. On one side was the hallmark of the Emperor Augustus. On the other, the stamp of their commander, Quinctilius Varus.
Varus ist aber erst 7 nach Statthalter.
In the year 7 AD, Varus became the governor of Germania. Therefore, it was only from this date that he could put his stamp on the coin. So we can say on the one hand, we have found no coins dating after 9 AD, and because these coins were produced starting in the year 7, they could only have been lost in the year 7, 8, or 9. This would indicate that we have situated the Varus battle in 9 AD.
The location of the forgotten battleground now seems certain. Archaeologists have also excavated a strange-looking mound at the base of the mountain. Their work reveals a man-made rampart some 600 feet long and 7 feet high.
We suspect that the Romans came from the east. That is to say, they came from this direction and marched along this path. They were attacked from different ramparts, which in our opinion, the Germans had built for the ambush. So far, we have excavated only one of these ramparts. That rampart lies over in that direction, at the foot of the Kalkrisa mountain. This is the old ground level, from the time of the Romans. It clearly marks the outer edge of the rampart. The Romans came along this path, just below here. Then they were attacked from the rampart and were clearly annihilated.
The construction of a rampart suggests Arminius knew which route the advancing Roman column would take. But how did he know? Wolfgang Schlutter thinks his knowledge of the terrain gave the Germans an edge.
Die römischen Truppen sind von Osten gekommen.
The Roman troops came from the east. Now, presumably, they try to get through here, between the Kalkrisse mountain and the Wien mountain range. But they had to admit it was impossible due to the high altitudes. They retreated and went around the mountain using the shortest path possible to surmount this obstacle. The Roman troops had two possibilities. Either they could march in a long queue for 10 or 12 kilometers, in which case they were vulnerable to attack from the side, or they could march in wide formation, but then they faced continual traffic jams at the narrow passage points. Imagine a three-lane highway narrowing to one lane. Then you get traffic jams for many kilometers. And that is exactly what happened here.
Schlutter's findings confirmed Tacitus's account of the battle. Varus led his army through treacherous terrain. On one side, Tacitus records, it was flanked by marshes, bogs, and swamps. On the other, by densely wooded hills. Here, they encountered the ambush. It is deathly quiet in the Teutoburg forest. An autumn rain chills the air. The Germans, invisible behind their earthen ramparts, patiently wait. Anticipation steals their nerves. In the distance can be heard the footfalls of the approaching Romans. Then finally, out of the mist, a golden eagle appears, the battle standard of a Roman legion. Troops, pulled apart by the long march, are caught by surprise. Trapped in close quarters, their spears and swords become useless. Combat is hand to hand. Within moments, the dying begins. Archaeologist Michael Geschter thinks the Battle of Teutoburg Forest was no battle at all. It was a massacre.
Diese kleinen Truppen römischer Soldaten, die eigentlich nur...
These troops of Roman soldiers were only trained to fight in open fields. They were not suited to ward off small, partisan attacks. Because of this, they were massacred man for man. Isolated troops were able to fight their way through, others surrendered and were butchered. And still others fought on, but were overrun by the Germans, who were more familiar with the terrain.
The overwhelming success of their ambush may explain why few German artifacts have been found. Mostly the fragments of a Roman army literally torn to shreds, their bodies and their weapons plundered.